welcome to another exciting edition. I'm here in the studio with Aliyu from Nigeria, Beatrice from Malawi, Susan Atara from Uganda. I'm your host, Lina Mkoko from Zambia. Today, they're going to tell us about the campaign they have this year, which is gender-based violence. Can you tell us about the theme that you have this year?
Okay, thank you very much, Selina Mukuku. The theme for our campaign for this year is YESS, Girls Can End Sexual Violence Against Girls and Women.
Okay, thank you so much. As you can hear, and many people out there, they don't know what is sexual violence. Can you enlighten more about sexual violence?
Yeah, thank you so much, Selina Mukoko. Sexual violence is the attempt or threat of sexual nature that results or is likely to result into physical and emotional ends. We also have some of the forms of sexual violence, and my friends will take you over it.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity. The forms of sexual violence are rape, sexual assault, intimate partner sexual assault. And to add on what my colleague has said, violence is any form of physical, emotional, psychological, or economical act done to someone without the his or her consent.
Thank you so much, Beatrice. So can you tell us what is the statistic that you have so far here in Zimbabwe?
Okay, thank you very much. In Zimbabwe, women play a crucial role in sustainable development. When they are educated, the society is educated. But then, gender-based violence undermines opportunities for women and denies them the ability to fulfill their potentials. In Zimbabwe, about 1 in 3 women aged 15 to 49 have experienced physical violence or even emotional violence. And about 1 in 4 women have experienced sexual violence since the age of 15. In an effort to reduce gender-based violence in Zimbabwe, UNFPA, with the Ministry of Women Affairs and Gender Development, sister with UN, which is the United Nations agencies, and civil societies, towards increasing availability and utilization of gender-based services by survivors, as well as reducing tolerance for gender-based violence in communities. The main thrust of the program is increasing awareness of gender-based violence and services. They provide healthcare services, psychosocial support, and legal aid to survivors of gender-based violence. 592, which is 42% of 1,425 people, are being assaulted sexually, and it has been reported as sexual violence. While 1,285 people survive sexual violence, which is being reported from 2013 to 2016. 93% received HIV tests, 41% reported to be rape victims, while 16% of the total survivors were followed up.
To add on what my colleague has said about the statistics, the program failed to meet its target on the centralized site, 8 out of 10. Awareness campaign, 16 out of 32. Sensitization activities, 16 out of 32. About 500, which is 12.5%, IEC materials were distributed, all 96 targeted supervisory were achieved.
2 of 8 district supervisory were trained, and majority of health workers, 25 out of 35, cited lack of awareness as major reasons for underperformance.
Thank you so much for this information. As you hear, listeners, together as girls and women, rise up and speak for self.
Together we can stop sexual violence.